Unless you've had your head in the sand for the last 6 months, you'll know that there is legislation being passed that will allow them to give you this vaccine, with or without your consent.
Massachusetts proposing legislation that would allow police to forcefully quarantine residents and even impose martial law without a warrant.
We have the emergency community, the Homeland Security, Federal Emergency Management Agency people talking about forced vaccinations, forced quarantines, basically the politicians running the show instead of the people who are from the medical community and know much better about the threat of this particular influenza. They're going to invoke all these various protocols for emergency situations, treating these people who don't want to take the vaccine, forcing children as a predicate to enroll in school, for example, to take the vaccine is going to cause quite a few problems here amongst the public in the United States.
There are also plans that will ensure that you do not freely travel, nor will you be able to really go anywhere without proof that you have had the vaccination at the point that the government mandates that certain levels of the population take the inoculation.
Now, if you don't know who Jane Burgermeister is, you should. She is the incredibly courageous woman who is filing charges against the World Health Organization. Let's hear her talk a little bit about enforcement.
Some people have written to us and they said, look, you're not going to have a policeman with a gun knocking on your door accompanied by a doctor with a syringe. They haven't got the resources to do that. How actually could they enforce it if they wanted to? How could it happen? What would be the sanctions which they have?
Well, the French government released or circulated to the heads of departments an internal document of 19 pages which outlined quite clearly their method. And this is what I assume is happening in every country. They're going to set up vaccine centers that are outside hospitals and GPs. Some of these are going to be secure. People are going to be told to go there, first of their own free will, and then they're going to receive calls, whatever, telling them to appear at a certain time. Then those people who do not come are going to eventually be collected and forced to go there.
Do the resources exist to actually do that? Because you're talking about transporting and enforcing and rounding up and making contact with hundreds of thousands of people.
They are assuming that the vast majority of people will either go of their free will, or when they get the call from, say, a police authority telling them to appear or the notification, they will go reluctantly, but they will still obey that call. And the number of people who will actually refuse to go and stay at home will be very small, and that there will be actually very few that need to be collected by the police.
Listen, let me explain this to you. If you want to shoot me or my child up, then you go right ahead and take full responsibility for any adverse reactions, because I'm telling you I'm opposed to it. I do not want it. Do not do it. If you're going to insist that the law requires it, you take full responsibility. I want you, school nurse. I want you, teacher. I want you, school principal, doctor, politician, to take 100% responsibility for the adverse reactions that may come from this event. If you are willing to do that, if you want us to believe these vaccines are completely benign, and there'll be no adverse reactions, then you shouldn't have any problem with that. You may have heard me talking about contracts over the last couple of years. I wonder if there's a contract that I could sign that would have me waive all of my rights and would turn me into a guinea pig for a bunch of big pharma criminals who could then test their products on me at their will, and I would have very little say in the matter after I had signed that particular contract.
Vaccines are required if you're headed to war, but Target 5 discovered that a frightening number of U.S. servicemen and women are having severe reactions, including a young Marine from Claremont County.
It's not a shot from a gun.
This is the worst cover-up in the history of the military.
But a shot from a syringe that's leaving some U.S. servicemen and women on the brink of death.
When the issue, I believe, of the use of the vaccine comes out, I believe it'll make the Walter Reed scandal pale in comparison.
I was never sick.
A passion for sports and a sense of patriotism prompted this Blanchester High School athlete to join the Marines on his 18th birthday. But a case of friendly fire in the form of a syringe would forever change his life. On November 28th of 2005,
David's unit was lined up for what he says was an undisclosed shot.
After that shot, I started swelling up. I gained 30 pounds of water. My eyes swelled up where I couldn't see. I started snoring. I developed a rash on my hand.
3 weeks later, Private Fay was back in Claremont County on his deathbed at Clinton Memorial Hospital. His kidneys failing, his body so swollen it left stretch marks.
I used to just pray to God, please take him tonight.
As David appeared to be dying, Cindy Fay began poring over his military medical records in search of answers.
The shot was never listed in his records.
The Department of Defense tells Target 5 all service members' vaccinations are documented in the individual's permanent medical record. But David Fay's military medical records revealed no shot on that day. Another Marine in David's unit tells Target 5 there's no shot listed in his medical records either, and goes on to say the people who administered the shot never told us what it was. In a desperate attempt to save her dying son, Cindy says she called the U.S. Marine Hospital at 29 Palms, California, to find out what kind of vaccine her son was given.
And she says, ma'am, that's confidential. I can't tell you what the shot was. And I'm like, well, my son's in ICU and he might not make it right now. I said, I really need to know. And she says, well, we can't tell you.
11 months later, David's medical records were mysteriously changed with a handwritten notation indicating the mystery shot was a flu vaccine.
The case of David Fay, nothing was put on his record. And then suddenly, flu vaccine appears on his record. Does that surprise you?
No.
David is one of a growing number of U.S. servicemen and women getting sick after receiving vaccines. And this highly praised Department of Defense medical officer is mortified. He doesn't want to be identified for fear of retribution.
Are there a lot of folks out there who've had severe reactions to these vaccines?
Thousands. It ranging on the severity from just joint aches and pains and arthritic symptoms to death.
The Department of Defense tells Target 5 it encourages healthcare workers and vaccine recipients to report adverse events. But the military never reported David Fay's reaction to the Centers for Disease Control and FDA.
I see the way propaganda and information war is waged against America's sons and daughters, and how patients are treated who claim to be ill from a vaccine. That's troubling. That should trouble America.
How are these young men and women treated when they claim to have had a reaction to the vaccine?
Like they're nuts. Like it's all in their head.
Do you believe that the Department of Defense is experimenting on these servicemen and women with these vaccinations?
I would hope to God not, but from what I've seen, I would have to say yes.
Now, if you've been paying even the slightest attention to the videos I've released over the past 2 years, then you know I make it my business to deal in facts that I can back up with solid research. The topic covered in this series of videos, however, is so vast, so far-reaching, and involves so many various players in the game, that following the leads necessary to bring you the facts have uncovered very interesting, although still possibly circumstantial, elements of the bigger picture. The main one of these is the RFID powder, recently presented by the Hitachi Corporation. In short, Hitachi has managed to make RFID chips smaller than ground black pepper. These chips are certainly injectable, and so far as I know, at the time of this broadcast, only able to be read from a distance of 20 to 60 centimeters. But you should bear in mind that the average door frame where a chip reader could be installed is not much further from the human body than that. Now here is where we leave behind hard fact and go and sit in the conjecture corner. 5 years ago, military personnel in the US injected with a newly released round of vaccines suddenly began to drop from stroke at a rate of 6 in 10. If the vaccines contained a test run of the RFID powder, they were possibly clumping together and blocking the capillaries in the brain, leading to stroke. A breakthrough came when the manufacturers devised a way to coat each individual chip in silicon, for whatever reason. No more signal interference, no more clumping. The chips slid right past each other. The sudden incidence of stroke dropped sharply after the breakthrough, even though the same vaccine was being administered. In each vaccine document included in the download pack, the repeated instruction is to shake the vial repeatedly between doses and to carefully observe the presence of an opalescent sheen in the fluid. The silicon coating on any surface tends to throw the light with an opalescent sheen, though admittedly a substance the size of ground black pepper would be visible to the naked eye. Now, you may want to brace yourself, because I don't make a habit of dealing in theories, but I do find myself wondering, what if they have actually managed to make RFID chips smaller than is currently being reported? It wouldn't be the first time we've been told one thing by a major media to prepare us for what is in fact well advanced beyond what they feel the public are ready to handle. And I find all of these documented facts to be interesting pieces of the puzzle, and I encourage you to use your own reasoning to come to the decisions that best suit you.